All right, so with the exporter kind of brought up to a much nicer, simpler interface, I want to do the same thing with importers. Right, importers still have this odd importer base mechanism going on. Not exactly the best. It's a little bit too front loaded. I just want to change it. I really do. Simplify it a little bit more, much like the exporter. So, I need to. What do we got going on here? Importer, exporter. Because that's the importers. Let me close the others. Go to the exporters. Change it to a global based. Okay. New. Export. Go register. Functionality. Go import functionality. Have a new struct. It's essentially the same thing as this. And then we also have these. Border. Importer. No, it's base. Two, 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 two. We want a new type. Importer, importer 2. So this will be very similar to the exporter. That's the idea. That's the wrong one. This is what I'm looking for. Wrong one again. Okay. These are basically the same thing. You could just do it in your copy paste. Change that for import. Oh, looks like client decided to die already. Okay. Okay, let's just restart this. Okay. Import space not defined. Okay, that makes sense. That requires log. No, that should be, yeah. Oh, I got it in the wrong folder. Thank you. Okay, so we got this going again. So now I need to convert, let's say, physics, include registrar, system voice. Oh, no, the libs YAML. Registrar, basically gotta do a new import registrar. Just basically a mirror of this. The registrar. So this is basically what I'm looking for, yeah. I have a bit of safety built into this, don't I? Yes, because yes. Actually, no, before I get to this point, I need to do the YAML version of this stuff. So that's currently still this. Let's see how this goes. This doesn't require registration, but this does. See, I'm still importing the functionality. It's just different. Just shifted to a different location. As opposed to exporter, which is all on the one. The idea here is to get rid of the generator class, isn't it? I mean, is it? The generator does serve a useful purpose, doesn't it? No, I'm going around this the wrong way. I do need the generator because the generator type. Yes, this is the generator type is the one that I like. If I'm importing, I may be importing from disparate sources. Some may be YAML, some may be binary. You don't really know. I can't generate an importer on the fly, can I? Actually, hold on. Maybe I can. No, I need to have the generator to figure that out anyways in the first place. So, no. This is bad. Scrap this. Mostly. Just, yeah, scrap it all. Reset. No. Importers. For register importer generator. Register importer generator. Okay. Okay, how would this realistically work? What would happen is, like in here, importer, I have the generator, right? So this would have to be much like the exporter, right? Well, the exporter doesn't register anything, but this would have to be registered. So I'd have to like. At some point, I'd have to call something along the lines of this bool for register. Something like this, which will then basically replace what I do in the application layer instead. So what I do in the application layer instead is on initialization, I have like add importer generator like that, right? Yeah. Ooh. I need like an instance kind of thing going on. Where's the test generator? It's sitting around in here somewhere, isn't it? There you are. It's a global generator. Realistically, no one would ever have to actually know about this generator, would they? No. So what would happen is I'd call add import generator. Okay, let's see if we can. Same thing on the way out. Oh, deregister. Should mean I can get rid of that. This basically, yeah, means I no longer require all these extra things floating around, which is just basically empty, right? Yeah. Right, I'm probably not exporting them. And I may want to deconstruct this object into something else, maybe down to like a well, I mean, this doesn't even have to be public anymore, really, does it? I can just shrink all that down. Wait, no. I still have this in way down here. So not quite. Just see if it. Okay, well, let's get this part. I guess I'll leave that. I'm just really trying to think of how to reconfigure the registrar. Okay, how's about this? We have void, sorry, faux physics. Wait, where is this from? Oh, it's just right here, okay. Okay, let's just shrink this down just a little bit. Let's go back to this point. This point works good. Then I'll update the visibilities ignore. That's great. Does work, right? 5, come on. Great. Place those 3 like that. And we got this, that's great. That, that, and that. Okay. Is there anything else I really need to do with this? At the moment, not really. Okay, how do I add? Importer data. I really need this, or I'll leave this as is for the moment, because I'm not interacting with the importer at this point. I'm just interacting with the generator for adding functionality. Ah, that's right. That is what I'm trying to do. So I'm not doing this, I'm just adding we'll have much like on the export side, which would be something like this. And we're not doing that, we're doing it to the importer generator. We're not doing it on a per importer basis, we're doing it on a per generator basis. Because there may be a bunch of importers. I mean, there's very unlikely. But they exist. That. So we're adding this functionality. First of all, we've got to make sure we don't actually already have it. Really? What? Stop that. Sync is ambiguous. From what? Okay. G-Sync. That's the global sync for this class type anyways. Add a new functionality, existing importers. It's not importers, I'm going through generators. Or just generators. Gotta go through all these, I'm calling that. Ooh, yeah. Oh yeah, that's right. We want to do basically the same thing on the way out. Okay, so that should work for that. Okay, back to the YAML importer thing. Time register import generator. I've done that. Now, as part of, let's say, physics YAML register. What's going to happen is I want to got this to have those. Where are the this is. This takes in this type. Then I go like, hey, if. Then I go into this stuff, if that. register that if the generator we were provided is the correct one that we're looking for, then we can add and remove this stuff. Okay, no errors yet. So let's see if we can change over physics right about here. That means going to registrar, we're going to have to, or what would be basic functionality. YAML import functionality. Same thing on the way out. Then in the application, I should no longer have to do this one, right? Let me just double check. Exporting the symbols. Good idea. Great idea. Just never. Okay, there's no physics right now, which is bad. Yeah, okay. Okay. Not great. Secondly, it's on release, not debug. Not great either. Whatever. I'll just quickly take a drink while this builds. Okay. Back, it should be, okay, let's try this now. Let's see what's going on. So we got that, going inside, we're registering, great. So now we have one thing in here, fantastic. Okay, I see what's going on, yeah. When I created the importer or created the generator. No. That still makes sense, actually. The generator should already exist, so I should be adding it right away, right? Okay, I added it. Yeah, and then I automatically remove it. Yeah, okay. It's all there. It's all there. So that means I no longer require this weird class thing or this. Or is this physics one? No, it is not. Registrar. This. These two functions go away. These can stay the same. I need the gen. Yeah, I need that. Yes. Yeah, I think so. So I wouldn't need this at all anymore. Okay, lovely, lovely. Position. Oh, and then I just want to change it up to be like. Import registrar specifically. There'll be another include somewhere else. Right here. Two locations. Okay, now we go to position include YAML 3D. Oh, position YAML import registrar. Basically the same as this, except YAML import. Not exactly sure why. Because this is still all the way in the bring up application. I see. I see. Very well. Got that, then we'll have these two functions. Actually, we'll just have them void again. To go down to where was it? This. Right here. That's that. We have on register. That's not the one I was looking for. Here we go. On deregister. Stop that so I can actually get the all this stuff to kind of go through. Because do I have, I do not have import registrar yet. Oh, come on. YAML importer generator is an incomplete type. Right, we don't need these ones. For this one, we can just blank these ones out. That should then mean nothing to return here. I better return for Imex functionality. That's something I really need to do because I'm just running around on the assumption that hey, everything's fine, everything's fine. Please disperse, nothing to see here. Okay. Okay. Yes, it does work. Perfect. We are getting there. We are so close. Okay, next is the rest of the components are actually in here in the bring up application itself, so okay, this is basically going to be import armature state. Technically, this is armature state. That, and that. Namespace. Great. Then we have these two functions, which I'll bring in and just reverse. Don't need to do that. Register. On register, okay. Okay, so we got generator, importers. Don't need that one. Don't need that one either. See, like this doesn't show like how it's getting all this stuff. It just kind of assumes, unless it's part of the import registrar. No, I don't know how it gets the stuff from. It must be getting it from, I don't know where, like all these. Oh, hold on. Wait, I'm looking at the wrong one. Function registrar. Yeah, I don't know where it's getting this stuff. There it is. Those YAML exception, the generator. We've got to include. Well, that's enough, actually. Okay, I got that. Yeah, just a basic functionality. The register. No, it's to bring up. Okay, function. Yeah, that'll be next. But at least does core work? What is core? Core is just the components, camera and that. Yeah. Just gotta make sure that that's fine. Looks fine. Perfect. So what's different about these? They're moved. Yes, entities, they're just completely new. That's fine. They got the stuff though. That's new as well. Yes, that makes sense. Okay. So it should mean this function registrar can go away entirely. No longer required in the application. Goodbye. There we go. Now it's a resource stuff. this, we're going to go to source, we're going to go to here, we're going to rm-rf, what is it, state import, state YAML. Bam, it's all gone. Another bring up thing, set of functionality that was really intermixed between the bring up application and real libraries is gone. That just leaves resources. Then that will mean I can pretty effectively working on the get to work on this last part and then clean up. So fo resource YAML import registrar. Or I could just reuse the current one, really. Close others. So here, got everything I need. Yeah. Close that up, go here, no longer require that, no longer require these. Maybe been one thing too much. Oh, or not. Okay. Sure, cool. May just been because it was stuck on a previous run. I all right. I suppose Okay, if that's done, then that should mean I no longer require this old stuff here. I don't need this anymore. Importer function, registrar. Nope, that's gone. Right. Don't need to run this anymore. This is gone. Okay, we can change this up to import registrar. Only requires two places. Now that's encapsulation. Yeah. Okay, let's have a look. This is still a bit of a question mark. Something that I need to kind of work the generator a little bit differently. Just move this to the top instead, please. Okay. Eliminating several inherited derived class types. Okay, so today I'm going to be dealing with the Imex libraries now that I've cleaned up and changed up both importers and exporters to use functionality registration framework. So what the first thing I'm going to be doing is like these extra headers that directly specify these types, these functions no longer have to be exported or made available outside, since like the entire registration process deals with that. So I can actually start removing these from being publicly available and again decreasing the surface area of like the exposed symbols. And of course, if these aren't exported, then there's more ability for it to inline such functionality. So that's what I'll do. So first of all, we'll start here since I got it open already for physics. That just decreases everything that's here to just these two headers. And then I need to wait for that to delete it apparently. Okay, that, change it down to that. Change this down to the local header. And I no longer have to export these. Shrinking them down to that. Do I export these? I do not. Okay. I guess these are, yeah. Move that down. Same thing here. Okay. So that's the first of a number to go forward with that one. So we got that. We'll go to position next. Libs YAML include. Move that down to here. Can't start with a number. Get rid of the export. That now becomes just local. Same thing here. Looks like position. Now we go for resource. All of these, that, not that one, that. Can move down to source. These ones. We want to remove these things, these items, right? Just close it up like that. And we don't need to export either. Next, on this one, close them up, that, get rid of the export. Great. Wait, did I get rid of export on this one? Yeah. Close all back down to the image. Nice. Remove those. Okay. Okay. That's those ones. Is there any others? No. Ooh, Imex. Hold on, did I even... No. ECS? This is an interesting one, because this is used by others. So these actually should still remain exported. Because these are used in other ones, so this makes sense. Model, IAM GUI, WSI, XR, YAML. Yeah, these ones make sense. Okay. These ones. Close all. Let's go quickly through them. Reduced. Sorry, what? Just deleted and then re-added. I didn't think there was that much change, but okay. Okay. Moved many. Frame work. Exported. Directories. Okay. Now, looking around. Okay, now what am I doing? Oh, yes, I need to deal with the fact that, like, not here. Is it here? It would normally be here. Yeah, we'll read position and stuff. I need to kind of get a better idea on how to deal with the keys. Because right now, these are just strings that I'm putting around the place. Not exactly great, especially on the resource side. If I check this code, maybe not. Yeah, here it is. Like, I got manual strings for it. What I probably should be doing is rather, there should be like a Armature definition key, like just returns the char star, const char star. That I can then throw about, because right now I just have it like a string view just hiding around, which is not great. So let's do something about that. Const char star. Would it even really need to be string view? Armature definition key. Do I really need definition? It's just really, so armature key. YAML key armature. I don't know, something like this. Because how does this do? This takes in a standard string, which is a key, which I presume. Okay, I can kind of clean this up a little bit, because I don't think I really need that. Okay. Let's see if I can actually just do standard string key then instead. Armature key. That doesn't really matter. What we'll have is on this side. Rather than just return C no name, we'll just have like this. Just right here. Then we can go into, let's say, the export registrar, wherever armature view 1 is used. Can I do this? No viable conversion from string view to that. Why is there no conversion from, like, maybe I just. Okay, what if that? Does that work here? That works here. Okay, I'm changing it over that because string view is not. Then I can also do this, right? Yeah. Okay. Place that one and replace that one. That leaves that one. Okay. That can also probably mean going up to here. Okay, we go to the generator. This is a map which does support that, I presume. So, what if I change it to be Cons Char Star? Like, does that work? I don't like it, but. That works fine. Oh. Come on. Why is there no implicit between the two? Okay, we will just do this. I'll just deal with it. Rather than this, we'll just do kind of. Really, fucking Clang is gonna die right now. Okay. That's temporary. This can be used twice, so I'm kind of okay with it. It's very, very weird. But I'll take it. Maybe not. Local key. What do I call it on an exporter? Register component fun FN. Okay, yeah, let's change that up. Instead, register component function. And deregister. Okay, we've got a whole bunch of little things done on that. So what's this go? The importer, yeah. Not quite on that one. That and that. That just kind of okay. Going back to the generator, not entirely okay with this resource. So I need to kind of here and here and here and that here. here and here and here. Then I need to replace them here. Those two and resource. Probably change that to down to that. Create resource. Create info definition. Really? Clang decided that. What? What? Why? Decided to break already. It just cannot format files. Why don't like? Why? Why? What happened? Will not be restarted. Cool. Why? Why don't you restart? Okay, well, yeah, that. Rather than dealing with strings, take string string. Types for clarity. Clarity. Okay, we got that. Now, that was originally a string view. Then I changed it. Y. because that. That should probably be a standard string. For one, it'll be local most of the time because these will be small enough. And I don't know if it'll be, yeah, so these should remain like that. We'll just return charcon star. So we've got the export registrar, we've got the import registrar for armature v1. Like this really have to be private? Maybe image, we're just going to do this. Material. Now we just complete the rest of them. Okay. Sure, that's going to work. Nope, wrong one. That one. Okay. Okay, so export registrar that needs to be changed. We have where was it? Was here, right? So that's snake case. Physics. Any interesting things in here? Need the keys for this. Really, no declaration. I mean, originally, why I had these as definitions is because there was also a declaration, but that's basically been superseded by just the ID number type system instead. So there's no reason to have definitions suffixed on these anymore. So I'll probably remove those in a second as well, now that I think about it. Wait. Where's the export for the rigid body? I don't see it. Oh, this is position. Wrong place. That collision shape. I got the resources, I got the 3D, I got these. Let's see if this even work. The answer is no. I have a position that I guess I'm just not reading somewhere. Why, what's going on? I imagine that this would have been it. Let's have a look. Yes, that would have been it. Okay, now we're back. It's a whole bunch of files, minor modifications, adding keys, and what have you. Now, what I'm going to see if I can do is try to remove the definition. So, what we got? That's been changed to the key. That's been changed to. Oh, this needs to be. don't need that. We didn't follow through with using string view. Armature image material, mesh, shader, vertex descriptor, keys. Okay, so what we got? Functionality. Mission. Not mistyping typos. So now we also got to do that didn't work. Why? Ooh, crap. Yeah. I forgot the bracket. Almost, almost, almost. Still works, right? F5 to clear out the old. F5 to go in. Good. These were a holdover, a remnant. Have been replaced. As unique types. Okay. Anything else to do with cleaning up these types, especially in here? Like, I can definitely see, like, I don't really need to have this split between the internal and this type, if like they're all technically internal. I don't really think I need to really bother with that. What's the faux log? Do I even have logging in here anymore? No, I don't. Maybe just a remnant of the past when I did. Before I had exceptions in here, I'll bet. Why do I have F-stream? Do I need it? I don't think so. Not anymore. Do I need to export? No, I do not. Do I have a string? No, I do not. There's always more to remove. Mm-hmm. don't have any log in here, so I don't really need to. Did I bring in log? I didn't even bring in log here. More. Okay, I think I can leave it at that. It's cleaned up a fair bit. I'm pretty okay with the importers then. Yep. All right, that's it for tonight. Cheers.